that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. It is yet another Thursday night when we come to you with the communion service. We come right into your home. And I want to say thank you so much for welcoming us to your home. Thank you for opening up your doors. Thank you for opening up your heart. I pray that the word that you receive tonight will have a place in your life and will bring change in your situation. I may not know what battles you are going through. I may not know what situation you are in right now. I may not know what your cry has been, but I know this one thing, that Jehovah knows. Our God knows what you are going through. Therefore, he has put a word in me that will speak into your situation and bring change in your situation. All you have to do is to receive this word and accept it as your word. Remember, when it comes to the word of God, you cannot hear it for someone else. You can only hear for yourself. It cannot benefit someone else. That which you hear, it will only benefit you. So let this word get into your spirit. Let it work in you. Then they will see the change that has taken place, and they will desire to receive this word, which will bring change into their situations also. It is the word that will affect your entire family. It will affect your entire business. It will affect your entire future, depending on how you receive it. Jesus said, be careful how you hear the word. How you hear the word. Because how you hear determines what the word is going to do in your life. So please open up your heart tonight and let us receive the word of the Lord. But before we get there, let me ask you, Joyce, to say jumbo, and then we hit the road. Okay, Joyce.
Amen. Praise the Lord and welcome to our communion service tonight. The word of the Lord is very clear that the word of God is a seed. And in this month of birthing, I pray that the word of God, that seed that will be planted in you this evening, will bring forth something in your life. A baby will be conceived in your womb and you will bring forth according to the word that has already been given to us for this month. So karibuni sana and enjoy the service.
Yes, this is Christmas season. And during Christmas season, we look at the birth of Jesus. We remember the birth of Jesus. And in remembering the birth of Jesus, we also acknowledge the work of Jesus, the accomplishment, and his coming again. And that's what the communion does for each one of us. So we've been looking at the narrative of Luke. We've been looking at the narrative of Luke. Concerning the birth of Jesus Christ. I pray that in the name of Jesus, that you will capture. You know, there is no slip of the tongue. When it comes to ministering the word of God, there is no slip of the tongue. So you capture what you hear. I know I've told you before, but let me tell you how I discovered that. Those early days when we started on KBC, Sunday morning, the cameras, the people would come. Set up the cameras and all the equipments. Tell me you are on. I would look at the camera and smile and say, this is the day that the Lord has made for us to rejoice and be glad in it. But one Sunday morning, I looked at the camera. They tell me I am on. And I have my smile and say, this is the day that the Lord has made. Then I forgot what comes next. And I said, for you and I to be happy and to rejoice in it. And the accuser of the brethren, the devil, Satan, that old serpent was right on my shoulder, whispering to my ear and saying, shame on you, Pastor Mark. How can you forget a scripture like that? How can you forget a scripture on national television? Shame on you. Are you going to preach? And I was fighting. The battle is always in the mind. I was fighting and I said, get thee behind me, Satan. I'm going to preach. And I was preaching and I'm fighting at the same time. And sure enough, I preached my message and I concluded. So they went to Nairobi and worked on the program and took it to KBC. The following Sunday, I was watching the program in my office during the change of the services. And I saw myself on national television. In those days, there was no other channel. There was only KBC. So I saw myself there misquoting the scripture on a Sunday morning. And then the accuser of the brethren, you know he never leaves. He is always looking for an opportunity. He was there saying, shame on you, Pastor Mark. How can you misquote a scripture on national television? What will people say about you? They will conclude you are a bogus preacher. All that stuff he was saying to me. And I was fighting and I said, get thee behind me, Satan. I preached the word. But something happened. You know, our God is a God of surprises. Our God is a God of miracles. I pray that this weekend, that he will surprise you. May God surprise you in his own ways. God surprised me in a big way. After the program went on air, the following Thursday, I received a letter. In those days, there were no cell phones. And phones were very rare. So people used to write their testimonies and send post by post. So I brought a letter. It's on airmail. And I opened up and it said, Dear Pastor Mark, I want to thank you very much for your TV program and your message last Sunday. More so for the very first words that you said. And this is how you said it. This is the day that the Lord has made for you and I to be happy and to rejoice in it. And this young man said, as soon as you said those words, a weight that had been sitting on me for a long time was rolled away, and I gave my life to Jesus. I got born again. Oh man, that lifted me up. What the devil was using to condemn me is what God used to bring salvation to this young man. And I want you to know that every time you hear the word of God, what you hear is more important than what has been said. In other words, it is possible to hear that which was not said, because the Holy Spirit will cause you to hear that which will build faith in you, that which will build confidence in you, that which will bring results in you if you have been crying out to the Lord. I pray that in the name of Jesus, that tonight you will hear that you have been crying for. You will hear the word of the Lord that will bring change. From that day I knew that what I say is not important, but what you hear is very, very important. What you hear is more important than what I say, because it is the Lord, the Holy Spirit, who causes us to hear the word of the Lord that builds faith in us, and the faith that brings in change in our situation. So we are looking at the narrative of Luke concerning the birth of Jesus Christ. But we started with the conception. We started with a conception, and we did see from Luke 1 from verse number 26, Joyce, would you read that for us just to remind us as a way of recap?
And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth.
Yes.
To a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph.
Yes.
Of the house of David, and the virgin's Mary. And the virgin's name was Mary.
Mary.
And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored. The Lord is with thee.
Yes.
Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying.
Yes.
And cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be.
Yes.
And the angel said unto her,
Fear not.
Fear not. Mary.
Mary.
For thou hast found favor with God.
You have found favor with God.
And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb.
You shall conceive in your womb.
And bring forth a son.
And bring forth a son.
And shall call his name Jesus.
And you shall call his name Jesus. Now, we looked at that, and we have followed all those verses until we came to verse number 31. I do not intend to go back to the other verses, but I want us to pick from verse number 1, that one, where he said, and behold, you shall conceive in your womb. You shall conceive in your womb. I want you to know that the word can only be conceived in the womb of your spirit. Every one of us has a womb. Some of us have two. You have the physical womb and the spiritual womb. The spiritual womb conceives the word of God. So the angel said, you shall conceive in your womb. When you hear the word, when you receive the word, first and foremost, it is conceived in the womb of your spirit. It gets into your spirit. And as long as it is in your spirit and you meditate upon that word now starts being transformed, transferred into the realm of the tangibility. Into the realm of the tangibility. Remember, faith is the evidence of things not seen. Things not seen. It is the evidence, the tangibility of things hoped for, which you do not see, but you hope. But faith brings them into the world of tangibility, where you can touch them, where you can now experience them through the five common senses. So your spirit womb is very, very important. That is where the word goes. And as you meditate upon that word becomes effective in your life. That is why it is important for you to have time of meditation. Time when you sit and you meditate on the word of God. Time when you read the word and you concentrate on that word. Some people call it chewing cud. That is, after you have heard the word, you go and chew cud. And you go through the word again. Remember, faith comes by hearing. Faith comes by hearing. And hearing by the word of God. Therefore, as you meditate upon the word, it builds in a spiritual strength. And that spiritual strength overcomes the physical, overcomes the sense world, the world of the five common senses. And you find you are now doing that which you could not do before. You are now doing that which is outside of the five common senses. So, the angel said to Mary, you shall conceive in your womb. You shall conceive in your womb. Now, he is talking about the physical womb that is found in a woman. Man has no physical womb. Man has no physical womb. So it's not possible naturally for a man to carry a baby. It's not possible because the baby is to grow in the womb. Okay, I will not get into that. But I want to know that the angel is talking to Mary that you are going to conceive in your physical womb. Now, for you and I, as I give you the word, you have got to receive it first. In your spirit. Receive it in your spirit. Let it be conceived in your spirit. Once the word is conceived in your spirit, it becomes a reality. That is why when you prayed and you said, Jesus, come into my life. Make me a new creature. Save me. Nothing happened to your physical body, but you felt there is a change that has taken place in your spirit. A joy came unto you. A confidence came unto you. A boldness came to you that you are able to say, I am now born again. I am a child of God. And the word of God now has meaning in your life. The word of God now has meaning. It has effect in your life. Why? Because your spiritual womb became alive. Now you have a spiritual womb where the word of the Lord is received and it brings in forth. Okay, now let's go back to Mary and the angel. The angel says, you shall conceive in your womb and that which you conceive, you shall bring forth. You shall bring forth a son. I want you to know that which is conceived of God cannot be aborted. The word that you receive in your spirit, even if they killed you, you cannot recant it. That's why in church history we read of people who are burnt at the stake in stadiums because of their faith. That's why we read that there are people who are fed to lions, hungry lions, but they could not recant their faith. Why? Because the word in them became so real and overcame the reality of the physical. How I pray that the word you receive, the word of healing, will overcome the reality of cancer. That it may overcome the reality of diabetes. Let it overcome the reality of that sickness, whatever you call it, or whatever it is called. When you receive the word of God, and the word is conceived in your womb, it rises up. It rises up and overcomes the reality of your predicament, the reality of your challenge. That is what is called a miracle. It's called a miracle. A miracle happens when the word of God in you rises up so much that now the symptoms of your sickness are drowned by the reality of the word of God, which has been conceived in the womb of your spirit. And what you bring forth is healing. I pray that tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ, as you receive this word, it will rise in you and overcome the reality of your sickness, the reality of your failures, the reality of your frustrations, the reality of your diseases, the reality of whatever is eating you up, in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, glory to God. Oh man, I'm enjoying this word. I do not know about you, but I'm enjoying it. I want you to know that when you conceive the word of God, it doesn't matter what pain may come in the physical. The word of God remains real. When the word of God is conceived in your spirit, it doesn't matter how much you have or how much you do not have of the resources of the earth. The word of God prevails above everything else. The angel told Mary, you shall conceive in your womb and bring forth a son. You shall bring forth a son. Now, when you move on, you will discover in verse number 34 that Mary asked a question. Mary asked a question in verse number 34. What question did she ask, Joyce?
Then said Mary unto the angel,
uh-huh,
how shall this be?
Yes.
Seeing I know not a man.
How shall this thing be? You are saying, I'm going to conceive in my womb and bring forth a son. And right now, I do not know any man. Mary knew that faith works in the now. She was not transferring it to the future, because she would have said, okay, thank you very much, angel. I will rush to Joseph, and then we can do the job, and I can conceive. That is okay. I have received your word. Thank you very much. But she knows that faith is not for tomorrow. Faith works in the now. That's why we are told in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse number 1 that faith now is. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now faith is. Now. You can read that statement without changing the meaning like this. Faith is now the substance of things hoped for. Faith is now the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So that word now is there to show or to indicate the timing of faith. That faith is not futuristic. Faith is not in the past. Faith is in the now. The evidence now. The things you hope for now. The things that you hear now. Mary realized that faith is in the now. That's why she asks this question. How shall it be? And up to now, I do not know any man. I know I am engaged to Joe. We are planning to get married in September or whatever month. But we are staying clean. We are not going like the 21st young people, 21st century young people who want to go testing before you are married. We are not doing that. We are staying pure and clean. Now, how will it be? And I do not know any man. In other words, I know to have a baby, you need a man. But I have not known any man in the now, and your word is in the now. This is the question that Mary asks. But when you go backwards, when you go backwards to Luke 1 and verse number 18, Luke 1 and verse number 18, you will find Zechariah also asked the same angel a question. He had asked earlier, what question did he ask?
And Zechariah said unto the angel,
Zechariah said to the angel,
whereby shall I know this?
How shall I know this?
For I am an old man.
For I am an old man.
And my wife well stricken in years.
And my wife is well stricken in years. In other words, Zechariah is seeing faith in the past. I am an old man. My wife is stricken in years. It is not possible. In other words, Zechariah is telling the angel, wacha kunihanda bwana. Don't talk these things to me. Can't you see? Can't you see how old I am? Have you seen that old lady of late? She is a gone case. I want you to know, my friend, that faith does not go by what you see. Faith is not determined by how you feel. Faith is not determined by the things that you touch. Faith is not determined by the things that you smell. Faith is now. It is standing in the word of God and saying, God has said it. I believe it. This is the difference between Mary's question and Zechariah's question. And you find the reaction of the angel is completely different. So the angel tells Zechariah, by the way, listen to me. I am. Look at that. Look at that, Joyce. What does the angel Gabriel say? Verse number 19.
And the angel answering said unto him.
The angel answered and said to him.
I am Gabriel.
I am Gabriel. In other words, I am not ordinary. I am Gabriel. Whatever you are saying, you have got to know who you are talking to. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. I pray that in the name of Jesus, that your eyes would be opened to know who is keeping you company. In other words, Zechariah, in the temple, you are not alone. In the temple, Jehovah is with you. In the temple, I represent Jehovah. I am Gabriel. I am Gabriel. And I have come from the great I am. I have come from I am who I am. Okay, keep going, Joyce. I am Gabriel.
That stand in the presence of God.
Who stands in the presence of God.
And I'm sent to speak unto thee.
And I have been sent to you.
And to show thee this glad tidings.
To show you this good news.
And behold.
Behold.
Thou shalt be dumb.
Because of your doubting. Because of your fixing your faith in the past. Because of not recognizing the timing of faith. You shall be dumb.
And not able to speak.
You shall not be able to speak.
Until the day that these things shall be performed.
Until whatever I have said shall be performed. It shall be fulfilled. Keep going, Joyce.
Because thou believest not my
because
words.
Because you did not believe my words.
Which shall be fulfilled in their season.
And my word, which is from God, shall be fulfilled in its season. I want you to know, my friend, the angel says, because you did not believe my words, you are not going to be dumb. You are not going to be quiet. You are not going to be able to speak again. And faith is now. And the word of God is now. Immediately, Zechariah became dumb. He could not speak again. Even when he walked out of the temple, after being there for a long time, he had to tell them to show the people with his hands, you go. And they perceived he had seen a vision. He beckoned them, you go. Why? He could not speak. I want you to know, my friend, I would rather you keep quiet than doubt God's word. I would rather you don't speak than doubt God's words with your words. Because the word of God shall never go back to him void. And right now, there is a healing that is taking place in somebody's body. Right now, there is a healing that is taking place in someone's liver. Right now, there is a healing that is taking place in someone's back. There is a healing that is taking place in someone's uterus. There is a healing that is taking place in someone's mouth. In your mouth, there is a healing that is taking place right now. Right now, the word that I speak is a now word. It's a now word. Don't take it to tomorrow. Don't push it back to yesterday. That was the problem of Zechariah. But when you go to verse number 38 of chapter 1, you will find Mary's response. Find Mary's response. After she was told, you don't need a man. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. And you are going to bring forth a son. What did she say, Joyce?
And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord.
I am just a handmaid. I am just a servant. I am just waiting to be told. I am subject to the Lord. I am under the Lord. I am obedient to the Lord. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me. According to thy word.
According to your word. Now, I want you to notice something. She did not even say, be it unto me according to the word of the Lord. But she said, let it be to me according to your word. Why? Because she recognized that this word is coming from God. Notice that Gabriel did not introduce himself to Mary the way he introduced himself to Zechariah. He told Zechariah, I am Gabriel who stand before God. But he does not introduce himself to Mary. Why? Because Mary already knows faith is in the now. Faith is in the now. And she says, let it be unto me according to your word. Somebody say that. Somebody make that your statement. Someone declare, let it be unto me tonight according to your word. According to the word you are speaking. Because I perceive you are a carrier of the word of God. Did you know that the anointing you do not perceive cannot benefit you? The anointing you do not recognize cannot benefit you. Right now, as I speak to you, there are thousands and hundreds of thousands of people who are benefiting from this word. There are other millions who are watching and they are saying, what is Mark saying? These preachers, all they are doing is looking for money. Someone is saying that. And someone is saying, let it be to me according to your word. Tonight, as we partake of the communion, let this be your statement. Let it be to me according to your word. Let it be to me according to your word. And the Bible says that the angel departed from her. The angel left. just as he left Zacharias dumb, he left Mary after he had given his message. Mine, my friend, is to bring you the word of the Lord. Mine is to declare the word of the Lord to you. Yours is to say, let it be to me according to the word of the Lord. According to the word that you have spoken. According to the word that God has given to you. I want you to know, my friend, that the word of God is alive. The word of God is powerful. The word of God is creative. And tonight, there is creativity taking place in your body, in your life, in the name of Jesus Christ. And I am speaking to every part of your body that needs replacement. Every part of your body that needs repair, it shall receive repair by this word. But that part of your body that needs repair receives repair. That which needs replacement receives replacement right now in the name of Jesus Christ. That when you see the doctors again, they will tell you, I don't understand, but you have a new heart. The hole which was in your heart is no more. That kidney which was not functioning is now functioning. We don't understand. That uterus we removed has grown again. These things don't happen like this. We do not understand. Let there be creative power taking place in your body right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Those fibroids are disappearing right now out of your body. By the time you wake up in the morning, they will all have disappeared in the name of Jesus Christ, because the word of God will never go back to him void. That infertility that has come into you is disappearing right now. That swelling that has been on your body is disappearing right now. That goiter is disappearing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak this to you as I hear in the name of Jesus, that you will experience a new day. You will experience a new season as we partake of the communion tonight. Let this be a night that you will forever remember. Let this be a night that you will remember all the days of your life. As you rise up tomorrow morning, as you rise up in the morning, your life will never, ever be the same again in the name of Jesus Christ. Because God has sent me, as he sent Gabriel, he has sent me to tell you that there is a miracle taking place in you. Yours is to say, let it be unto me according to your word. Let it be unto me according to your word. The word of God is working in you. It is working in your situation. It is working in your body. It is working in your business. I'm hearing the cry of a business lady. A business lady, you have been crying and saying, oh, they have gone away with my money. You have given money out so much that your business is not moving the way it should be moving. I see a command being given to them to start looking for you, to bring back that which was taken from you. And that who has been stealing from you is exposed. This week will not pass before the thief in your house, the thief in your business, the thief in your shop, the thief in your office is exposed in the name of Jesus Christ and to the glory of God. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Someone declare, that's my portion. That is my portion. Capture that word and run with that word. As we partake of the communion right now, I want to say to you that your life is being transformed. I want to say to you, your life will never be the same again because the word of God is working in your situation. But the question is, Do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? Have you received him as your personal Savior? If you have not, please pray with me right there where you are. God is doing a miracle in you. Pray and say, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, tonight I have heard your word. I have received it. And I acknowledge that the work done at the cross of Calvary by Jesus Christ was for me. And right now, willingly, I open up my spirit that you may come in and make me your habitation. I receive you tonight as my Lord and my Savior. Because I pray in Jesus' name, amen. Father, I pray that you will put the seal of the Holy Spirit in the life of this individual who has prayed that prayer for the first time. Give them the courage, the confidence, and the boldness to testify that they are born again. They are children in the kingdom. I break every curse of the enemy, the power of sin against their lives. I break it in the name of Jesus, and I declare them free in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Congratulations, my friend. You are now born again. You can partake of the communion. You can join us as we partake of the communion. If you are not ready for the communion, get ready very quickly. Get some elements, some bread, a cup, and then let us partake of it together. Now, those of you who are ready, I want to say that is the word of the Lord for you. Receive it and run with it. And write to us and tell us what is going on. Tell us what God has done. Now, Paul, I will always read the 1 Corinthians. You can also read from John or Luke, but I prefer reading from 1 Corinthians, chapter number 11, from verse number 23. Paul writes and says, "For I have received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take it, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Lord, as we partake of the bread tonight, we remember your broken body that was broken for our healing. Thank you for the spectacular miracles that have taken place in the lives of your people, in Jesus' name. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." We thank you, Father, for the blood of Jesus that was shed. I pray that the purposes of the shedding of the blood shall be accomplished in the lives of your people, wherever they are and wherever we partake of the communion, in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Okay. Now let us partake of the communion together in the name of Jesus. Serve those in your house. Now, let us partake of the bread together. Let us partake of the cup together. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for every viewer who has partaken of the communion. I thank you for every viewer who has heard this word. Lord, seal this word with signs and wonders, miracles in their lives, in their situations, for your own glory. Because I pray in Jesus' name, and everybody said amen. Thank you so much. May the Lord richly bless you. We'll see you again this coming Thursday. But before we go, it's time to worship the Lord with our substance. Now get your offering, get your tithe, get your sacrifice, and put your sacrifice, your faith, your offering at the altar. This is the House of Bread altar and the Majestic City altar. Out of this altar, you have received the word of the Lord. So it is important to keep the fire at the altar burning. you can use our M-Pesa pay bill number. It's right there on the screen. And then when it comes to the account, tithe or offering or other. Or you can do a direct transfer from your bank account to the church account. The church account is in Equity Bank, and the account number is right there. And all you can do, you can use the Equity Bank M-Pesa pay bill number 247247. And the church account number is right there. Or you can write a check direct to Deliverance Church, LCCI, or Deliverance Church, Majestic City, and send it. Now, once you have done that, please send me the confirmation. Send me word. Send me word confirming that you have sent your offering, your tithe, your prophet's honor, that whatever it is. Just send me the word in the name of Jesus, and I will get back to you. May the Lord richly bless you. Have a super, super, super week. But before we go, let me ask you, Joyce, to bring in an invitation to our services, Joyce.
Amen. Praise the Lord once again, and I do believe that you have received the word of the Lord this evening. It's always our joy to welcome you to our services, and so I want to take this opportunity and ask you, as we are coming to the close of the year and you have not visited us, you have been following us online, before the year ends, kindly, please, it's an appeal I'm sending to you, just come and join us. We have two locations, you can choose either of them. The first is the House of Bread, which is located at the KPCU building along Haile Selassie Avenue, next to the famous Marigiti Market. So that is the House of Bread, and we have two services. The first is at 8 a.m. and the second is at 10:30 a.m. You can choose either of those services. The second location is the Majestic City Church, which is located along Kangundo Road at Makongeni Stage. And it's a place, you can't miss it. There's a big tent, white tent, and our signboard there, Majestic City, right on the road. You cannot miss it. Majestic City Church. And there we have only one service at 10:30 a.m. So if you're within that area, kindly come, pay us a visit before the year ends. It'll be our joy to see you. So karibuni sana, have a good night. We'll see you on Sunday. Amen.
Thank you so very much. May the Lord richly bless you. We love you and we value you, and we are praying that this will be your best Christmas season ever. This will be your best Christmas season ever. Some of you have already started receiving Christmas gifts from the Lord by receiving your healing, your miracle in the name of Jesus. We'll see you on Sunday and next Thursday. God bless you.